In this annual revisit, I will remind you all why adaptations are both battering rams and scapegoats at the same time, proving yet another stupid aspect of this horrible community. Every time an adaptation is announced, the fanboys of the source material use whatever fame it has and project it onto the adaptation before it's even out. And they have no idea how the quality of the adaptation is going to be like. But they hype it regardless because they see it as a battering ram, a way for their show to break into the mainstream. Not the adaptation, the source. Because most people hate reading and would rather watch something, it's much easier to check out a series based on the recommendations of the source readers. Does that guarantee anything? No, because an adaptation is never completely faithful, and most of the times it changes a lot of tiny things. But it doesn't matter since quality never was the point. The source readers hype the adaptation so that the source will get more popular. They don't care if it deserves it, they just want it as a confirmation bias for liking it before it was cool. And this here is the problem with any show that increases its popularity too fast. Since it's not done in an organic way, that is, people slowly learning about it and slowly checking it out, there are bound to be many who do not like it, because they never found it on their own, based on their specific tastes, but rather checked it out because it's popular and therefore it has to be good. It's a fallacy everyone is using as if they don't know popularity has nothing to do with quality. For the same reason, junk food is widespread despite not being healthy. Anyways, a lot of people check out something that was never within their tastes and obviously don't like it. And when someone doesn't like something, he thinks of reasons why he doesn't like it, which makes the problems of the show very obvious to non-fans. These problems don't have to be limited to the source material. They usually exist even in the source, and it can be things that the fanboys are ignoring because they are fanboys. They ignore the negatives or present them as positives. So when non-fans are pointing out these problems, the fanboys are obviously getting angry, and we get the usual internet drama where the tiniest of things are enough to make something controversial. This drama wouldn't exist if fanboys weren't constantly trying to make their favorites more popular and left them niche as they deserved. Fanboys are delusional creatures. They are not content with feeling special for being one of the few who love a title. They demand everybody else to like it as much. And when that doesn't happen, because there are thousands of different tastes, and therefore no show can please everyone, they attack everyone who doesn't like it. Although it was obvious that such a thing would happen, therefore it's a problem they created. Defending the titles you like is not a bad thing. If people got the wrong impression about something, you should be explaining what exactly is going on. Adaptations tend to mess up a lot of details that make more sense in the source, so pointing out the differences is a good thing. The issue here is the same as before. The fanboy is hyping the adaptation and then calling the adaptation bad compared to the source, because they never actually cared about the adaptation. They were hyping it, which is mistake number one, because you must never inflate the value of something you have no idea about, for the sake of making the source more popular, which is mistake number two, because you must never force people into checking out something they had no intention of doing on their own, before attacking the very people they invited into their fandom, which is mistake number three, because it's you who wanted this, and now you regret it, but at the same time you don't admit it. Essentially, what began as a battering ram eventually becomes a scapegoat. Adaptations are always proven to be attracting the wrong type of people. They reveal the problems of the source, and they cause a lot of unnecessary drama. The fanboys do nothing but blaming the adaptation for the issues animonlies have, or if that doesn't work, the animonlies directly, because they can't accept responsibility for their own mistake, much less admit their favorite show has problems they ignore. And that is why you must never trust the hype, never care about popularity, never listen to the fanboys, and always let a title be as famous as the amount of people who are specifically looking for what it has to offer. Anything more than this is like throwing a rock at the window and then blaming the people inside for complaining about the mess you caused.